got spirit, yes I do. This winner is recognized for her eagerness to spread the word about the Maine Trout Club and organize group runs in the Lewiston Auburn area. She comes out and supports runners as they train and run races, and even when she's sidelined with an injury, she's there, cheering everybody on. She has encouraged countless members of the Maine Trout Club to attend Tuesday nights with Bob Rayner, as well as long runs on Sundays throughout the entire year. Through her dedication to the sport, many of us have been able to challenge ourselves to succeed at longer distances. I'm pretty sure she stepped up to be on the board. She came to one meeting. I'm pretty sure that means she's committed. She has spirit. Congratulations, Donna. Bonnie Air. Race Director of the Year. Again, we've got so many good races to choose from and so many wonderful directors. They all just pull off a great job every year. This club is fortunate to have, like I said, many terrific RDs. They all deserve big hugs and countless hours of volunteering and hard work in making everything happen just right. This particular race director is on top of his game. He's organized, he's charismatic, and he pulled off a major success for a big-time first-year event. Race the Runways was awesome, and we'll be again next year, or this year. Congrats, Mark.
I was born in 19.
John Fialka Award. This award recognizes club members for their special achievements and efforts, often over the course of several years. This year it goes to two individuals. Michelle Durgan and Chris Lydon for their fantastic job with the Turkey Trot over the years. This race has grown significantly and raised a ton of money for local charities. I think it was over $5,000 that they gave to the food shelf. Lots of food that we send there as well. They're stepping down this year as race directors. They put in good work. We will miss them greatly. And congratulations, Michelle and Chris. And as president, I have leave to recognize a member of the club for going above and beyond the call of duty. This person I'm giving the president's award to is a great runner, always there on Saturday mornings. He's the meticulous secretary of the board of directors, often keeping our discussions on the board on track, keeping me on track. He spearheaded the strategic planning process this year with lots of meetings, countless meetings. Because he's so capable, we accomplished a lot during this whole process. The club will be better for it in the future. Congrats and thank you, Jim. MTC Runner of the Year. 2458 at the YMCA Fit Fest 5K, 2459 at the LA Bridge 5K and Patriot 5K, 5549 at Portland Trails 10K, 4247 at PT 8K. These are times I have trouble finishing in some of these races in. I don't know if I'm 77 years old, if I'm going to be able to keep that kind of pace, but I sure know John Howe can, and he is the MTC Runner of the Year male. Congratulations. The female MTC Runner of the Year is not here either. Quick poll, who do you think won it? It's Jeannie. She's awesome. Just go to athlinks.com and search Jeannie Hackett's name on there and just look at the times that she posts. Just incredible. Every year. And congratulations, Jeannie, for just showing us how to do it and inspiring us to run a little bit faster next time. One more. This is the big one. We don't give this one out every year, but this person certainly deserves it. Bob, would you mind? Bob is going to introduce the winner of the MTC Lifetime Achievement Award.
Any of you who have been involved in organizing a race, no matter how small, know how much work goes into organizing a race. Now imagine organizing a race that has 3,500 runners. Now imagine organizing two races that are about that size, and a third race that's also pretty big. Of course, I'm talking about Howard Speer. When he first took over as race director of the Maine Marathon in 1998, the previous year, the marathon had less than 800 runners, counting the marathon and half marathon together. Within 3 or 4 years, we were up to about 2,000 runners. Now, of course, the last 2 years we've sold out. We've reached our cap of 3,500 runners. And most importantly, not only has the race grown in terms of participation, but it's also grown in terms of quality. And I think all of you who have participated in the marathon over the years know how good of an event it is, and it's all organized by volunteers, and Howard is the backbone of that event. In addition to that, he also directs the two Sea Dogs races, which have also become huge events. The Mother's Day 5K is the biggest 5K in Maine, and the Father's Day 5K probably is only 3 years old, but that's growing too, and before long that'll probably be right up there with the Mother's Day 5K. I think we all owe a great debt of thanks for all the work that Howard has done over the years. Giving him this award doesn't do nearly enough to thank him for all he's done, but it's a start. So please join us in thanking Howard Speer and congratulating him on a Lifetime Achievement Award. If this doesn't mean that you can retire from all these races.
Can I go up on my feet? Just in the middle.
So just to recap, if you want to claim an award for somebody, if you're going to see them, feel free to come up and grab it. Otherwise, awards will be available at Maine Running Company later next week, or early next week, rather. If you won one of the race entries, please come up to me after class here and drop me your email. I will coordinate that. Other than that, congratulations to all the winners. Thank you again for volunteering and being part of the Maine Track Club. It's a great organization. Love everything that it does. And I'm personally very excited to be part of this group. Love running with everybody. One more final little announcement. We just started a new group run on Sunday mornings. Lisa and I are hosting a run down in Cape Elizabeth at the local Buzz, which is right by the high school there. It's a great little coffee shop right there. It's 8 o'clock on Sunday mornings, very relaxed pace. Anything, 3, 4, 5 miles, run walking is fine. If you want to go longer, you can do that too. Tons of great routes, but hope to see you there on Sunday mornings at 8. Otherwise, all the other great runs we've got. Portland at 4 Alice Bakery, Saturdays at 7. Yarmouth at Saturdays at 7. Check the website. It's on there. Thank you very much, and meeting adjourned.